What's up, guys? I'm Jessica Lasaka, and welcome to Weak Sauce ASMR episode part two. Just kidding. I'm starting today's episode off with a bang. After 4 years of marriage and trying to conceive, a young married couple from a village in China were perplexed as to why they weren't getting pregnant. The couple claimed that they had been copulating regularly and that it was an unusually painful experience for the wife every time. They finally decided to see an OBGYN to see if they had any reproductive complications going on. They went on to describe to the doctor exactly how they performed intercourse, and after further examination, the doctor concluded he was putting it in the wrong hole this whole time. The doctor then broke it down for them to let them know they had been doing it wrong the whole time and that in order to make a baby, the P goes in the V, not the B. The doctor sent them home with a sex ed handbook and some helpful tips, and it also shed a light on the lack of sex education that some parts of China have. But there's a happy ending to this story. The couple revealed that they're pregnant with their very first child, and as a gift to the doctor for teaching them how to properly do it, they gave him 100 eggs and a hen. One woman's Facebook post went viral when she went on a tirade against her family and friends after she canceled her wedding. She starts off the post by telling everyone that she and her fiance had broken up due to irreparable damage and that they were staying civil for the sake of their son. However, she then drops a huge bombshell blaming the cancellation of her wedding on the lack of support from her family and friends. So the post is really long, but basically she goes on to explain that she and her fiance met when they were 14, then they had a kid, then they became financially stable and were able to save up $15,000 for a wedding. However, when they calculated it and found out just how much weddings actually cost, they found out that their dream wedding would actually cost them $60,000. They finally narrowed it down to two dream venues. So, you know, like any normal person, they consulted with a psychic. The psychic then told them to go with the more expensive option. The venue was in Aruba, and since it's a destination wedding, it would end up being $1,500 per guest to attend this wedding. The bride asked for $1,500 cash up front so that they could pay for this extravagant wedding. Her maid of honor pledged $5,000, her ex's family pledged $3,000, and she even had a few guests RSVP and sent her the $1,500 check. Due to the expensive nature of this wedding, all in all, about 8 people RSVP'd, which aggravated the bride to no end and made her go on this tirade on Facebook. This woman was so ungrateful, selfish, and inconsiderate that she decided to go on this Facebook rant and also announce that she was going to take all the money that she received to go on a solo backpacking trip for 2 months in South America. That guy dodged a bullet, that's all I can say. The Paraguay National Police have become the embarrassment of their country. 42 high-power rifles went missing from their armory and it went unnoticed for a really long time. It wasn't until these guns started showing up on the black market, going for as much as $10,000 a gun, when they decided, you know, maybe we should check the armory and see if any of our stuff is missing. And lo and behold, they check, and it's all plastic rifles in their place. Currently, no arrests have been made, but Paraguayan media tweeted that this has been the most embarrassing scandal in the police force's history. A new prank has taken over the internet that was inspired by the Netflix show Magic for Humans. The prank is based off of one of the stunts performed by Justin Willman. He starts off the trick by having each subject sit in a lawn chair. He then proceeds to put a blanket on top of their head, and when he lifts the blanket up, he asks the audience to react like...
They did not vanish. You cannot see them or hear them.
Ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Oh my God. Wait, let me see. Oh man, it's just a freaking huge chair. No one's gonna get one. It's so cool.
So now people are reenacting this prank with their loved ones at home, and the reactions are priceless. Check it out.
1, 2, 3.
What? Dude, we're sad. We're sad.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Dude! We're sad.
Guys, that's it for me. I'm Jessica Lasaka. Stay saucy.